Hi YouTube, welcome to Super Adder. Today I'll tell you some 16 steps to follow so that you will get best mileage out of your vehicle. So as I am driving a 7-seater vehicle, so people normally they say you should not expect mileage from this kind of big vehicles, but still you can get good mileage by following some simple steps so that you will get even good power along with good mileage with your vehicle. So I'll just tell you what are all those tips. First, maintain optimum tire pressure. So if you have a tire pressure monitoring system, it will be very helpful to monitor your tire pressures regularly, and you will come to know when you have to get it in flat. So always keep the tire pressure good so that friction between your tires and the road will be reduced and you will get good mileage out of your vehicle. The second thing is driving style. So don't accelerate too much and don't brake too much. So panic braking and unnecessarily accelerating will waste the energy and it will reduce your fuel efficiency. Then plan your trips accordingly. So if you have one or two small trips, like with a very less distance, you will get very less mileage because engine will take more energy to heat, like vehicle will take more energy to heat up the engine. So when engine is getting heat up, you will get very less mileage. So if you have short trips, like every time the energy will get wasted to heat up the engine. So if you have longer trips, like all trips together, plan accordingly so that you will get best mileage out of your vehicle. Then next thing is aerodynamics. So aerodynamics of the vehicle will increase the fuel efficiency. So you can't change the design of your vehicle, but clean your vehicle, polish your vehicle so that external surface of your vehicle will be smooth, and it will reduce the friction of your vehicle with the air. So normally people say there is 2 to 5% variation you will get because of your vehicle surface smoothness. So keep your vehicle always clean, polished, so that your vehicle surface is smooth and you will get good mileage out of your vehicle. Then one more thing, if like so many people they install the roof rails, they keep luggage overloaded above the roof rails. So unnecessarily installation of roof rails with some newer looks or something, it will hinder the airflow, so it will cause more friction. So better to avoid if you are not that much using the roof rails, better to avoid installation of this kind of additional fittings outside the vehicle will reduce your mileage. Then use right gear and use right RPM. So always try to take your vehicle to the topest gear so that you will get good mileage. Then shift your gears from 1500 to 2000 RPM in case if you are using a diesel vehicle. So that will give best fuel economy also, and even it will give the best speed if you are changing the gears between 1500 to 2000 RPM. So if you have automatic vehicle, try to use manual shifting of the gears at even at lower RPM itself so that you will get good mileage out of your automatic vehicle. Then keep your car very lightly so that you don't overload the car with more garbage in your boot space. So reduce unnecessary things, like if you are driving in city or something, if you don't use the safety or any some tools or something, you might have never used those things. So in those cases, you can reduce those weight. It will slowly improve your vehicle mileage. Then don't keep your vehicle in idling condition for more time. So if you are keeping your vehicle in idle condition for 2 to 3 minutes, it's fine. If you are stopping more than 3 minutes, you just can switch up the engine. Or some newer vehicles, now they are coming with automatic start and stop engines. So that will give best mileage. But in your case, if you don't have that function, you can switch off the engine if you are halting for more than 2 to 3 minutes. Then schedule your services. So get your vehicle serviced periodically for the smoother function and good mileage. So changing the oil filters and cleaning the air filters, or periodically changing the air filters, will give good fuel and air mixture. So it will give proper utilization of your fuel. So it will give best mileage if you have periodically service your vehicle, and even it will make the engine smoother. Use the AC efficiently. Don't put, as soon as you get into vehicle, put the AC in the maximum cooling mode. Just roll down the windows and switch on the AC with some optimum 25 degrees with optimum blower capacity of 1 or 2 points or something, or 2 to 3 points something. So when you roll down the windows and switch on the AC, it will blow the hot air outside the vehicle. So very easily and very quickly, with less power utilization, it will cool your vehicle. So that will save a lot of fuel. Then add some additives to your fuel. So as I am driving the diesel engine, I am using add-on. So add-on diesel is available in Indian Oil Super, Indian Oil petrol bunks. So you can mix that with your diesel. So that will give very smooth engine feeling, and it will clean the injectors of the engine. So that will give best mileage. Always park your vehicle in the shaded area. So parking in the shaded area will keep your car very, very cool. So no need to put more power on the AC as soon as you sit inside, because your vehicle will be in cool condition. And another thing, if you park in hot sunny environment, what will happen is it will melt the grease which is applied in some parts of the vehicle. So the melted grease will attract more dusty particles, and dusty particle will accumulate in those parts. So that will give more friction to the smooth moving parts of your vehicle. So park your vehicle always in the shaded area, so that you will get optimum efficiency of your fuel without applying more friction onto the moving parts. Always fill fuel in cold condition, because fuel pumps normally they measure the fuel in terms of liters. Diesel or petrol, any fuel, if you heat, it will expand. So when it is expanded conditions, the density of the fuel will be very less. So the lower the density, you will get very less fuel efficiency. The higher the density, actually you are getting more fuel out of it. So always try to fill your fuel in the early morning, so that you will get higher density fuel in cold condition if you fill it. Always try to do reverse parking at home, so that morning, as soon as you switch on the engine, you no need to take the front and back of your vehicle when your engine is in cold condition. Keep the fuel above the quarter tank always. That will help pressurizing your fuel pump, because if you have less fuel, fuel pump has to work more, and there will be more stress on the fuel pump. If you have a little higher level of the fuel, it makes the fuel pumping very easy, so that the energy will be saved and you will get more fuel efficiency. Then use cruise control in case of highways. Don't try to use the cruise control in case of crowded areas. But in case of highway driving, use cruise control. So cruise control will not only reduce your driving fatigue, but it will increase the fuel efficiency by avoiding unnecessary acceleration when you are going in the slow. And maintain safe following distance. Don't stick to bumper traffic. So if there is a vehicle in front of you, and if you are just behind the vehicle, unnecessarily you have to give sudden accelerations and sudden braking. So always maintain safe distance so that you will be having enough time to put brake or enough time to give acceleration. So always maintain safe distance. Happy motoring. If you like the video, please subscribe. Thank you for watching. Super Rada.